Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Neon. I'm here with Geeky Sparkles.
Hello.
And we're going to talk about Rooster Teeth because, you know, Rooster Teeth, everything's fine. It's all fine.
That's over right. There
at Rooster Teeth. Actually, Rooster Teeth is having more problems. This is on top of the layoffs, on top of the shopping fiasco they had where they had a hacker break in and compromise their, they had the shopping cart.
Oh, I missed that one.
Mage cart, we'll talk about that. They're having more people leave Rooster Teeth. I don't know if it's their decision or the company's decision, but clearly things are not okay. They're not okay. So we're going to talk about that before we get into the video. Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants. We're at about 90,000 subs, hoping for 100,000 soon.
Yay, so close, guys.
Thank you very much. This article coming from Bounding in the Comics, I'll put a link in the description. Ruby lead animator Ian Kedward leaves Rooster Teeth after 7 years, some good. Then there was all the bad.
Oh.
So it seems like more stuff is coming out now about the working conditions at Rooster Teeth not being that great. A lot of crunch time.
What we've heard.
Yeah. Disclaimer. We've actually had former Rooster Teeth employees and actually one current employee come to us and tell us about the working conditions there. We're the ones that talked about Grey Haddock being blamed and Genlock being blamed. And not long after we did some videos on that, they did announce a bunch of layoffs. We also have some other people in and around the animation industry coming to us and telling us that, yeah, Rooster Teeth doesn't have a very good rep right now. And they're part of Warner Media, which, of course, is cutting corners at every opportunity. And the only reason Genlock Season 2 is apparently getting made is because it's going to HBO Max, and HBO Max is footing the bill. So, here we have another, you know, longtime Rooster Teeth animator leaving. But things are fine here.
It's all fine now.
Yeah, veteran Rooster Teeth animator Ian Kedward recently announced that he would be leaving the company after 7 years, seemingly referencing recent behind-the-scenes frustrations as a reason for his departure. We know we've had people come to us. They said it's not good over there. On January 10th, Kedward, who served as a lead animator on Red vs. Blue, Ruby Chibi, and the core Ruby series, so he's a big deal, tweeted that his time at Rooster Teeth was all wrapped up and done, while also alluding that all the bad that had apparently defined his last days with the company, stating that he was going to be taking the longest, deepest sigh and just relax.
Oh, that's pretty bad.
So he worked on a season of X-Ray and Vav, Caboose's Guide, 3 seasons of Ruby Chibi, 4 seasons of Red vs. Blue, 6 seasons of Ruby. Didn't work on season 5. So he's a big deal. He was there for a lot of
long time. Through a lot of their different, you know, shows and such. Well, did you say this is coming from Bounding in the Comics? So
yes.
People can go see it. Okay, I wasn't sure if you said
it. Yeah, we'll put a link. Now, Hirohei talked about this a couple of days ago, and I guess there's been more that he's trying to clear up because people are like, oh, well, it's just a grunt animator on
Chibi. It's not. It's not a grunt animator on Chibi.
No, many outlets refer to him as a sole animator on Chibi. Kedward followed up his tweet by clarifying his roles, playfully declaring that he demands recognition. So he was a lead on all of it. Chibi, Red vs. Blue, Ruby, Caboose's Guide, there. I mean, I just saw people saying I was only lead for Chibi. I demand recognition.
Yeah, you know what? He's probably joking, but at the same time, he's probably like, hell. I mean, I know what he feels like. We've built things up and got told that we didn't do anything. And it's like, oh, hell no.
Yeah.
You're going to acknowledge what I've done. I don't, you know, I'll do it as a joke, but deep down, I'm like, F this. You know, screw you. You're not going to tell me I'm less than I am.
Yeah, so Kedward's departure is the latest in a series of personal shakeups, and we'll talk about that. He's not the only one that left in recent weeks. We had Lawrence Sontag departed from Rooster Teeth and Inside Gaming. He was the editor-in-chief of Inside Gaming, and he's departing Rooster Teeth. This was back in December.
Yeah.
December, and he had a big, long message regarding his time leaving Rooster Teeth before Christmas. My reasons for leaving are complicated and probably beyond what a notepad screenshot could convey. The simplest version is that I discovered a number of opportunities I could best pursue on my own.
Yeah, I'm trying to be positive.
So this is like, look, we're talking people are leaving Rooster Teeth. There's like one a week anymore, one a month. And of course, you know, the big one right after we had Rooster Teeth employees coming to us was at Warner Media. Cut a bunch of staffers.
Right.
Now, this wasn't the first.
Yeah, we heard there was more, but you didn't hear about it.
Yeah, they tried to keep it under the rug. They tried to keep it hush-hush, but apparently they left a bunch of people go in the spring of 2019, too, and they didn't want it getting out because they didn't want people to panic. But if you're working at Rooster Teeth and you're not panicked, Check for a pulse. Because it's not good. I think your time is about up. I think once Genlock gets done and HBO doesn't bankroll it anymore, I have to wonder.
Yeah.
You know, when they're getting rid of lead animators. But yeah, a lot of people have been cut from Rooster Teeth. And of course, this is, you know, more bad news with, well, okay, they had their one VP was accused of beating his wife.
Yeah.
We had that in the headlines.
But that wasn't Rooster Teeth's fault. Just cause,
No. But you go out and search for headlines for Rooster Teeth, and then they had the big Mage Cart attack.
Yeah, I didn't know about that.
Yeah, so they got
hit. I missed this somehow. Did you do a video on it?
I did.
I wasn't in that video, so that's why I don't remember it.
Yeah, so there was basically it would trick people into thinking that they were paying through the Rooster Teeth store, but it was actually like redirecting them to another site that looked like the Rooster Teeth site, but it wasn't actually the site. So, I mean, on top of everything else, layoffs, massive layoffs, you know, their shopping cart thing gets attacked. They're cutting back on the Rooster Teeth merch, I guess, in Australia. They're shutting down their Australian store. They've got their VP out there beating his wife. And now they've got more animators leaving. I'm like, but things are fine.
It's all good. It's okay.
4 months ago in the Rooster Teeth subreddit, Rooster Teeth is fine and layoffs were to be expected after so much merger and acquisition activities. And here's an explanation from someone in HR who doesn't work for Rooster Teeth.
Yeah, well, first of all, do we ever want to believe someone in HR?
No.
Let's be honest. If you worked for any company, you know, the HR person is not your friend. Anyway.
No, when you see the HR person in the office when they call you in for a private meeting and they've got paperwork, you're in trouble.
Right.
I've been there. I'm like, oh my God, it's the HR lady. I never see her unless
Well, I mean, I want to clarify, not the thing HR people are bad, but they're always the ones who have to bring the bad news.
Bring the bad news, right?
It's their job to give the bad news. So people don't, you know, really want to befriend or, you know, hang out with the HR people.
Oh man.
Ideally,
you should only see the HR person when you first get hired and probably when you sign off when you're ready to leave on your own. If the HR person is there before you expect them to be there, that means they've got a cardboard box ready for you, too.
Right. We are the HR people here, so, you know.
But, yeah, it's bad, people. You know, all these Rooster Teeth defenders are like, oh, it's not that bad. No, it's bad. And this is part of Warner Media chopping expenses. Now, this kind of flies in the face of sister company Crunchyroll getting a fancy schmancy new office. Mm-hmm. And this is coming from Hiro Hayes. He's got a website, a blog out there now. But we talked about this fancy schmancy office a couple of days ago. Now, I have heard from Animation Industry Insiders, trademark.
Yeah, the ones that we don't know because, you know, they're going to all get us, you know, copyright struck and off of Twitter because, you know.
Yeah, because I had questions. I'm like, how is it that Rooster Teeth is facing all these layoffs, but Crunchyroll, and even though they downsized their convention and all that, they outsourced it to Repop, how come they went and got this fancy new office? And the answer I got was, oh, this was a done deal a couple of years ago. On the current management would never let them do this, but they already signed the paperwork for it back when they were able to, you know, spend a lot of money on stuff like High Guardian Spice.
At this point, they could have a lease. What happens when the lease is up? Because, you know...
Well, it was explained to me that they could possibly, maybe... Depends on how things go. They could just sublet this space out to another company.
Oh, make some money.
Make some money off of it. Because, you know, I don't think AT&T being the way they are right now, pinching all the pennies they're pinching, and we're hearing about all these companies getting shut down virtually overnight and layoffs. You know, do they really need a bike rack? Do they really need a sushi bar?
Wait, that's their office is a sushi bar.
I think they have a sushi bar or something. I don't know.
Oh, my God.
But, like... You know, these companies are being streamlined, and Crunchyroll, now I think they're doing much better than Rooster Teeth, but eventually...
It's all going to be rolled together into one anyway.
Yeah, it'll all be part of HBO Max.
Right.
And that's it. So, you know, enjoy it now, guys, because I think AT&T being the way they are, eventually it's going to come to an end. Or maybe this will be the home office of... Crunchy Teeth or Rooster Roll.
Bro, there you go. Because they already have it. They could send some of their other companies into that office and share it or whatever. It's already established. But here's the thing. It's like Crunchyroll, they have cuts and stuff too? And then they're just bragging about their office?
I don't know if they didn't have as many cuts as Rooster Teeth has.
But then but then they're the ones who went and paid for High Guardian Spice and all that with the subscriber money. So your subscriber money is paying for them to have a sushi bar at their offices.
Yes.
But I thought the money was supposed to go to have new animated shows done and animators in Japan.
Yeah, I don't think the animators in Japan
I'm just pointing this
out. Are working in the same kind of conditions.
It's like a tongue-in-cheek little thing here. But I'm just saying, yeah. You know, oh, there's like a fake, like, little, you know...
Yeah, we've got the cherry blossom.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's like a fake little cherry blossom festival going on.
It's like Epcot.
If I wasn't mistaken, people were upset about High Guardian Spice because the money they thought they were giving it for subscriptions and stuff, and that's what they raised subscriptions and things were for, was to because it was going to be helping actual animators over in Japan have better conditions, have more money. And then they turned around and did this, you know, in America, and then now they got this office with fake cherry sacro festivals going on.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, that's up to Warner Brothers, but as I understand it, nobody is safe from the Warner Brothers knife, and it's very possible that they could, you know, be getting some cardboard boxes of their own and be moving their stuff out if Warner Brothers decides they're not making enough money and they have to relocate these people someplace else because this office is too much,
right.
Too expensive.
I'm not saying people don't deserve good workspace.
No, not at all.
But I mean, it's fine. I really honestly don't care if they
I
have
would like
this
to work
workspace.
There. I'll be honest.
What I'm just saying is, you know, the problem people are going to have with this is because they were being told that, we have to raise the cost of, you know, the subscription rates because we have to, you know, expenses are going up and because we're going to send money for animation, you know, and help people in Japan. And then after they take more money from people, they show this big new office where you don't really need like a sushi bar and a bike rack inside.
Yeah, I think subscribers are going to have problems with that. But they were having problems with Rooster Teeth because Rooster Teeth promised that they were going to, you know, get new episodes of Genlock first, and now HBO gets them first.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, yeah.
And when you do subscriber programs like that, it's, you know, you're basically, instead of having one boss, you've got, like, thousands of bosses.
Right.
You know, so I don't know. But, I mean, personally, I think that this probably isn't going to last long term unless Crunchyroll is really bringing the boom. And they might be, because, you know, anime is doing better.
Yeah, anime is doing better. It's doing better than other cartoon shows that are American-made and stuff.
But Rooster Teeth is screwed. I mean, there's no... It's Rooster Teeth is... This is the end. We're seeing the end of Rooster Teeth, and I think they'll probably just roll them into another division of Warner Media, for sure.
They'll roll them into Crunchyroll, and they can go have sushi and the fake cherry blossoms.
Crunchy cock. Crunchycock.com.
I don't know what they're going to call it. I really doubt that. You know?
Cock roll. I don't know what they're going to call it.
They rooster roll, maybe, but they're not going to call rooster it cock roll.
Cock
you know?
Roll.
So, I mean, I'm just like saying.
You ready for anime? You ready to roll with the cock?
Crunchy teeth, maybe, but, you know, I don't. Or crunchy rooster. I don't think they're going to call it crunchy cock. I don't know.
Crunchy teeth, and then you'll have the poor Japanese animators being like, but we don't even have dental.
Yeah, well, you know, we don't have dental either. So there's that.
So don't work for us. We don't have dental.
Yeah, we don't even have dental. So there you go.
Anyway, we're going to wrap this one up.
Yep.
Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, and we'll talk later.
Bye.
Hey, guys. Thanks for watching Clownfish TV. Please consider supporting the channel. Go to clownfishsupport.com. That's clownfishsupport.com. And if you want to join our community, go to clownfishtalk.com. That's clownfishtalk.com. Please subscribe. Ring the bell for notifications. We will talk to you next time.